Hey guys. So there's a big test coming up. Like a really big test. In fact, you could probably say it's the most important test I've ever taken in my entire life thus far. And it is no other than step one, which I've been dreading for 2 years. In fact, I think I've been dreading this test for more than 2 years because you know about this test as an undergrad. I've known about this test since I decided I wanted to go to med school. And now I'm taking it next month. So it has been years that I've known this test was going to show up in my life. And here it is, next month. How crazy is that? If you guys have been following my vlogs, you guys know that I have already started studying for step one. I mean, we've been studying since day one of med school, but I've started my review for step one probably, I would say, about a month ago. I've been doing anywhere from like 20 to 40 practice questions per day using UWorld, and I've been reviewing those practice questions. I've been making Anki cards on all the things that I get wrong or other concepts from the questions, and I have gotten a lot of things wrong. And I've made a lot of Anki cards based off UWorld thus far. Like, I think my average right now is like a 52% on UWorld, and I've made it through about 25% of the question bank. I'm really hoping that once I pass the 1,000 question mark, I start to see an uphill trend. A lot of people tell me, don't worry about what you're scoring on UWorld, use it as a study resource, don't use it as like a self-assessment tool, just make sure that there is a positive trend happening. And actually, UWorld is the only resource I'm using. I decided that, you know, if I thought about using Pathoma, Sketchy, all those things, trying to get like rewatches in of everything before a step, I was just going to stress myself out. I was gonna get overwhelmed trying to watch every single video all over again. So I'm basically just using UWorld as my review for step one. So like you guys saw at the beginning of the video, I'm using the Motivate MD planner to keep track of my step one study schedule. I'm also gonna be using it to have all my reflections, track my day-to-day progress, all that kind of stuff. In fact, my friends over at Motivate MD actually sent this to me to keep track of my step one schedule, which is really awesome. This is actually the second planner of theirs that I've gone through. And I'll tell you guys a little bit more about the planner later on in the video. So at the beginning of the video, you guys saw me writing things down in the planner, and I was basically just writing down some of the major things that are going to be happening during my dedicated period. In case I didn't mention this before, or if any of you guys are watching my videos and you're not like in medical school or planning on going to medical school, step one is our first of three big board exams. We have step one, we have step two, and we have step three. And step one we take at the end of our second year, which is where I'm at right now. And it's basically this big, you know, basic science test that covers all the pathology, all the pharmacology, the anatomy, physiology, microbiology, genetics, literally everything that we learn in our first years of med school is all tested on this exam. Now, the big difference between the step one that I'm taking and the step one that anyone has ever taken before is that I'm actually going to be taking it pass-fail for the first time that it's ever been offered as a pass-fail exam. And you guys might be wondering, Shaun, if it's pass-fail, why are you even worried about it? Why are you stressed out? Well, even though it's pass-fail, I still have to pass the exam. There's always a potential of not passing. There's gonna be some sort of threshold. I'm still stressed because I have to sit here for hours and hours every single day studying. It's the holidays. I have to miss out on like family time and all that kind of stuff to study for this exam. It's still a pretty stressful, you know, situation, still a stressful exam to have to take. Even with it being pass-fail, there's still a lot of content on it. There's a lot of things I don't know, and there's a lot of studying I still have left to do. So my dedicated study period officially starts on December 20th, and that's gonna start with the UWorld 100 question practice test. The following days after I take that first practice assessment, I'm basically just going to review it. I'm gonna do my Anki cards that are rotating. If I manage to review all 160 questions, you know, over the next like 2 days after, I'll do some more practice questions using UWorld. And then December 24th and 25th is Christmas and Christmas Eve, of course. I'm going to have to study that day. I have it marked off in my planner, but there's no way that I'm not gonna do maybe like 40 practice questions on each of those days. I just can't see myself being able to finish UWorld if I take more days off. During the following week, it's gonna be practice questions every single day. I'll probably do 80 questions per day on days that I'm not doing practice exams. And so I'm gonna do 80 questions from the 27th all the way to the 1st, which is through New Year's Eve and New Year's. I'm gonna have to do it. Like I said, it's just unavoidable. I'm gonna have to study on the holidays this year, but there's gonna be next year that I can enjoy with family and friends. And of course I'm gonna see them this year, but I'm gonna have to suck it up and I'm gonna have to study and go into dedicated. This is something I knew was gonna happen and I made my schedule accordingly. Week three of my dedicated block starts on January 3rd, where I'm gonna take the NBME 200 question practice exam, and the same thing is gonna follow. I'm gonna spend the next few days reviewing that exam, going through all the questions I got wrong, making sure I learned those concepts, even going through the ones I got right, making sure I like knew why I got it right. And then if I manage to finish all the reviews, I'll do more practice questions on UWorld, and then I'll take a practice exam pretty much much every single week after that. So the following week, on the fourth week of Dedicated, I'll take another 200 question practice exam through NBME, and then I'll take UWorld 2 on the 17th. So that's gonna be week 5 of my Dedicated block. And then week 6 starts the 24th, where I'm gonna take an NBME exam. And then January 26th, 2022 is the first official day that step 1 is pass-fail, and that'll be in the middle of the week. I don't have to worry about it because I'm not taking it on that day or before that day. I'm gonna do the free 120 questions that is recommended for us to do a few days before our exam on the 27th. And then right there on January 31st is my step 1 exam. That is the day that I sit down and I take this exam. Now, this is a pretty basic study schedule, you know, going through practice exams, reviewing the practice questions, doing other questions on, you know, the days that you're not doing exams. That is kind of just the general way that everyone studies. Like I said, I'm just gonna do UWorld. Unless there are some concepts that I'm just like really not understanding and I really have to go into like Boards and Beyond or Pathoma or Sketchy, I'm not gonna branch out into the resources because I just can't handle that many resources at this point. I've used all those resources to get to this point, so it would be review to go back to them. There's just not enough time to tackle everything. I can't rewatch everything. I really just have to do the practice questions. The explanations are amazing in UWorld, and I feel like I've already learned so much after just doing 25% of their question bank. And I feel like after like 6 practice exams and, you know, doing the other 75% of the question bank, I'm going to just learn so much more. Another thing that I haven't written in my planner yet is that I actually do have a research symposium on January 29th, which is 2 days before I take step 1, which at first I was like, I shouldn't go to a research conference 2 days before. But then I was like, you know what? Just like the MCAT, there's not a whole lot you can do the 2 days leading up to your exam that's really gonna make a difference. And so it's probably better to just like, you know, do something else those like last 2 days, or just like take them lightly, you know, do something to kind of relax and kind of forget about the exam a little bit. And I figured doing a research symposium is actually perfect to have 2 days before. I can spend my morning presenting my research, kind of unwind, kind of switch gears a little bit, and then I'll have the rest of the day to do some review. I'll have the following day to review a little bit and just kind of relax, and then I'll have my step 1 exam the following day. So like I said earlier, I'm using the Motivate MD planner to track my entire studying schedule because, you know, I need to limit my distractions while I'm studying. So I figure actually keeping something that's more paper rather than like on my computer to like keep track of my studying is probably a better idea, so I don't get more distracted. And I think it's actually gonna be nice to have everything handwritten. I don't usually do handwritten things, but last time I did with their planner, I really liked it. And what's also nice is they have a lot of like room at the bottom of the pages for like, you know, reflection, everything. And then they have a bunch of these like extra pages in here, like tons of them, that are full of motivational quotes. They're full of like priorities lists. They have like things that, you know, you can write what you're grateful for. You can do daily reflections, today's wins, how I'm gonna improve. And these are like all perfect things to like be tracking while I'm studying for step 1, especially someone like me who kind of keeps track of everything. I vlog everything, you know, it's kind of doing the same thing, but within this planner. And it'll kind of be easier as well to like talk about what I'm going through if I'm kind of like writing it down as I go, because then I can report back to you guys by kind of having it all checked in here. It's gonna be really, really nice. I'm gonna have the link to Motivate MD's website and their planner in the description box below. Make sure to check it out. They have other services as well, like a pre-med app. They have application review services. They've got essay review services. They just have a bunch of really useful stuff for pre-meds, and their planner is just one of those things. They even have a bundle for the planner, so you guys can actually save some money by buying 2 at once, or you guys can save money using my coupon code Shaun10, which gets you 10% off of any bundle. You can use that on the planners, and you can also use Shaun10 on any of their packages on their website as well. If you guys have any questions about Motivate MD, you guys can actually contact my friend Becca, who's amazing. I'm gonna have her contact info on the screen right here and somewhere in the description box below as well. She will answer all of your guys' questions. You can reach out to her whenever if you have any questions or concerns about Motivate MD. Thank you so much again to the team over at Motivate MD for sending this over to me and for supporting me throughout my journey in medical school as well as studying for step 1. So yeah, guys, that is basically my plan to study for step. It's gonna be a long 6 weeks. I'm really nervous. Just doing my pre-dedicated has been absolutely nerve-wracking. It's been a lot of stress. I'm tired. I've been hanging out with my friends a lot. I've been seeing my family a lot. But even then, having this like weighing on you, knowing this exam is coming up, is still something you just can't get over. Even when I'm out and about, even when I'm like relaxing with my friends, I'm still thinking about it. It's like on my mind. I should be studying more. I shouldn't be relaxing. But I'm trying to keep up with things like seeing friends, family, going to the gym, exercise, all that kind of stuff. regardless of the step one schedule. That's also really another important thing that I wanna close this out with is that even though I'm going into a dedicated 6-week schedule of studying, life doesn't just stop because I'm studying for step one. Things are gonna come up. There's gonna be life events, there's gonna be family events, there's gonna be friend events. I'm gonna have to tackle them as they come. I can't plan for everything. All I can do is, you know, kind of have my ideal schedule down. I can follow it as best as I can, but I'm probably gonna have to adapt. Things are gonna happen, and I'm gonna keep you guys updated along the way. When it comes to my channel during this time, I'm not too sure yet what I'm gonna do. If I can vlog on some sort of break day, or if I can somehow manage it throughout the week, I will. It's just gonna have to like take a backseat on priority. Maybe I'll do like a once a week upload of like my progress and just the way that I'm feeling, like a sit down video like this. I think that might be the most time efficient way to do it, and also very therapeutic for me to kind of get things off my chest and keep you guys updated on the journey. But again, I'll figure it out as I go. But for now, I want to thank you guys so much for supporting me up until this point. It's been, you know, a long time since I've been in med school, and if you guys have been following this journey, I just really appreciate it. Your support means a lot to me. It's been a long journey so far. It's not nearly close to being over, but again, I really appreciate you guys. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and happy holidays to all of you. I'll see you guys in the next one.